Hello, my dear students. Welcome everyone to the channel Physics is Fun. Today we have another very interesting problem. It's a spring block system. There are two blocks having masses small m and 2m. They are connected by a spring whose spring constant is k. Block A has mass small m, block B has mass 2m. Initially they were moving with velocities u and 2u respectively. Now you applied a constant force capital F on block A and 2F on block B. Question is, what will be the maximum extension of the spring? Okay, so without any further ado, let's get along with our problem. So in order to do this problem, the first and the foremost approach that you must understand is these two masses, they are interacting with each other by the spring force because they are connected by a spring. Okay, so what happens? So these two blocks are interacting with each other as they are connected by this spring. Okay, so we can convert this two body problem into a one body problem by using the concept of reduced mass. So reduced mass of this system, we can write it as mu. So mu equals to m1m multiplied by 2m. So m1 m2 by m1 plus m2 m plus 2m. So this comes out to be 2m by 3. This is the reduced mass. So reduced mass of the system is 2m by 3. Now what is the initial relative velocity of the blocks? So initial relative velocity, maybe I can say velocity of block B with respect to block A. Okay, so I can write initial velocity of block B with respect to A. So that will be 2u I cap minus u minus I cap. So this is nothing but 3u I cap. Now what is the final relative velocity? So when the spring has extended by maximum amount, please see this. So when x equals to x max, both the blocks move together with equal velocity, then both the blocks move together with same velocity . So therefore what you can say, final velocity of B with respect to A is actually zero. So there is no relative velocity when there is maximum separation between them or the spring has got extended by a maximum amount, because if there is relative separation still going on, how can that be maximum extension of the spring? So now there is a very, very easy trick. What is that trick? We must understand. So we have converted the two body problem into one body problem. So we can apply work energy theorem or energy conservation principle also. So what we can say that by ECP or energy conservation principle, what we can say that half mu V final relative, or I should write V initial, in this case V initial is greater, so half mu V initial relative square minus V final relative square. This is the loss in potential energy. This is the loss in kinetic energy of this particular spring block system because the velocity has become zero. Relative velocity has become zero. Okay, please understand this. This is whose kinetic energy? Of the reduced mass of the system. So two body problem has become one body problem now. So this plus work done by the external force has converted into elastic potential energy of the stretched spring. So this is half k x max square. This is the most important equation. Now let's get into step 2 of the problem. In step 2 of the problem, you applied force F here, you applied force 2F here, right? And this particular system has mass M and 2M. So total mass of the system is 3M. So question is, what is the acceleration of center of mass of the system? So acceleration of center of mass of the system is basically 2F minus F. So if I write it vectorially, 2F minus F I cap by total mass, which is 3M. So it is F by 3M I cap. This is the acceleration of center of mass. Now when the system is moving, you just think, so this particular system's center of mass is accelerated, so it is a non-inertial frame, so definitely there will be some pseudo force. So if I consider this particular block, so there will be a pseudo force, it will experience a pseudo force. And what is that pseudo force? M A, center of mass. Okay, and here this particular block is also, there is a net motion in this direction, right, of the center of mass, because it is in the I cap direction. So pseudo force will act in the opposite direction, so it will get a pseudo force 2m multiplied by ac. So this is the pseudo force that it experiences. So now let us assume that this particular block gets displaced by x1. Suppose the block is displaced by x1, and this x1 displacement has occurred owing to the action of these two forces, and this block has displaced from here by x2. So what is the maximum extension of the spring? X1 plus x2. Alright, so what is the work done by the external force? So therefore work done by external force will be, for this block, if I say F plus M AC multiplied by x1 plus, for this block, 2F minus M, sorry, 2M AC multiplied by x2. And what is M into AC? It will be F by 3. Okay, so here also you will get F by 3. F by 3 means 4F by 3. So this is 4F by 3 x1, and 2F minus 2M into AC means 2 into F by 3. 2F minus 2F by 3. So it is again 4F by 3. X2, and this can be written as 4F by 3 multiplied by X max. Why X max? Since X1 plus X2, this is equals to X max. Okay, so external work which is done by the applied forces is 4F by 3 X max. So what we can write, therefore W external equals to 4F by 3 times X max. So this is my equation number 2. So let us now zoom into equation 1. So in equation 1, what have we got? Half. So half mu. What is mu? Mu we obtained. Mu. Where is mu? Mu is 2M by 3. 2m by 3, v initial relative is how much? 3u. So it is 3u whole square minus v final relative 0 square, because at maximum separation both the blocks are moving with same velocity, okay, in the same direction, so relative velocity is basically 0, plus work done by the external force, how much is that? 4F by 3 X max. And this whole work is getting converted into elastic potential energy, which is half KX max square. So very clearly I think you can see that this is a quadratic equation of X max. Now if I solve this equation, I will get the value of X max. Okay, so a little bit of simplification. So this will give me m by 3, and 3u whole square, 9u square. So that 3 and 9 will cancel. You will get 3mu square plus 4f by 3 x max equals to k by 2 x max square. Now let us multiply throughout by 6. Okay, so what do we get? 6 threes are 18. 18mu square plus 8f x max equals to three k x max square. Okay, so if I write it in my standard form, it should be like this: 3k x max square minus 8f x max minus 18m u square equal to 0. So this is my quadratic equation. So that pretty much sums up our discussion. So the maximum expansion or the extension of the spring which is connected between the block is given by this expression: 4f plus minus square root of 16f square plus 54mu squared k whole divided by 3. Okay, that is the expression. So this was a pure mathematical step, but what is the most important concept in this problem? When you do this problem, you must understand your step one, that you have converted this two body problem into one body problem. Why? Because they are interacting with each other. These two blocks are interacting with each other by spring force. Okay, so you may convert this two body problem into one body problem for the sake of simplicity, which we have done, and we have reduced the two body problem into one body problem using the concept of reduced mass 2m by 3. Find step two, find initial relative velocity between the blocks. Final relative velocity will be zero. It is very, very important. So both the blocks are moving with same final velocity, okay, at maximum separation. So next thing is, as a consequence of that, what we can see that the kinetic energy has decreased, right? So this loss in kinetic energy entirely converts into elastic potential energy of the stretched spring, provided there are no forces acting on the blocks. But here there are forces acting on the blocks. So center of mass will accelerate only in the direction of net force. So very, very important concept is this one, that acceleration of center of mass will be net force by total mass. Very important. So acceleration of center of mass is the net force acting on the system divided by its total mass. All right. So here, what is the net force? 2F and F. These are the two external forces. Spring force is also there, but it is internally acting from both sides. So 2F minus F. If there was friction, we should have considered friction. No friction is there. This plane is smooth, so no data is there. Mu is zero. So 2F minus F, I cap, that is the net force, total mass 3M. So you can find out the acceleration of the center of mass of the system. So center of mass of the system is progressing in this particular direction. So the blocks are connected with that center of mass, right? So it's a non-inertial frame, so there will be pseudo forces. So this block will experience pseudo force in this direction, so will this block, right? So based on that, you can find out the net work done. Work is done not by the external force only, but also by the pseudo force that comes into play. So the total work you found out in this particular method, and then all was needed was substitution and solving a quadratic equation. So I hope you found this problem useful. It helped you to clear certain fundamental concepts of center of mass, spring force, work energy theorem, okay? And this is a very, very important and interesting concept, that when the blocks are at maximum separation from each other, then only the spring will have maximum extension. So when the spring has extended by maximum amount, then please remember that both the blocks are having same velocity at that instant. Because if they had different velocities at that instant, that will not be considered to be the point of maximum extension of the spring. Okay. So I think that you found this problem very useful. And see you once again with another interesting problem in the next video. Till then, all of you take care and love physics.